Romania and Bulgaria accession to the Schengen area.
Yeah.
You mentioned that you support the accession of Romania and Bulgaria.
Yes, because I don't see any reason for not giving access, and I know that including for the transport of goods, it creates burdens because it takes more time to pass the border. Anyway, they can't pass the border, so it's just a sort of punishment which has no justification. Because I know that the Bulgarian authorities, Romanian authorities, are as good as the others of the European Union. Not better, maybe, but not worse compared to the Greek, Italian, others. But we don't prevent that we still have some problem in the Schengen area of lack of cooperation, of lack of common policy, European Union policy concerning immigration. But it's not the problem of Romania and Bulgaria. I think accession of Romania and Bulgaria in Schengen area should come now, and there is no reason to block that. Just populistic reason and hypocrisy. One.
Last one. In the next week at the plenary session, an important issue to debate in the Economic and Social Committee, European Committee, will be the Transatlantic Partnership on Trade and Investments. What should we expect from this debate, which will involve European commissioners and...
I think it's an interesting debate. There are various opinions about this TTIP in the European Union, you know, but I think on one side we considered that, of course, it can create opportunity. On the other side, there is big fear that the Europeans can lose their identity, can lose some of their protective regulation. I take the example of GMO, genetic modified organ, where the European Union has a much more advanced protection system for the consumers than the US. Plus, we have a problem of jurisdiction. The Europeans don't accept some of the requests of the American. I think we should find a balance agreement. And for the time, it's not clear that we'll get it. For example, you know that the Americans are very protectionist, so we hope a lot from this TTIP agreement, but that the Americans will open the market more than they are doing, because today they are very restricted. For example, in public procurement, the European Union is very open, the US is very closed. You cannot access to public procurement in the US. It's very difficult. You know, the U.S., we have this Buy American Act. We don't have a Buy European Act, where in the U.S. the privileged products are done in the U.S. So I think the debate will show that we want this agreement because it's positive, but not if it's not in the interest of European Union citizens and companies. And this will be probably our message. And we cannot pay to have this deal any price, including at the cost of safety regulation for food safety of our consumers. We are not ready to pay the price for that. But globally, it's a good idea. I think probably we'll come to a minimum agreement.
Thank you.
You're welcome.